डायरेक्ट एंड इनवर्स प्रोपोर्शंस. विल अंडरस्टैंड दीज टर्म्स विद सम एग्जाम्पल्स. द फर्स्ट एग्जाम्पल इज इफ कॉस्ट ऑफ 5 पेंस इज रुपीज 30 देन फाइंड द कॉस्ट ऑफ 25 पेंस. यू कैन सी इफ यू बाय less pens, if you buy 5 pens, the cost is 30. If you buy more pens, if you buy 25 pens, obviously the cost will be more. Means if you buy more pens, the cost will be more. If you buy less pens, the cost will be less. Now let us see second example. If a car travels 80 km in 5 liters of petrol, how far will it go in 14 liters of petrol? Here, the distance covered is 80 km in 5 liter of petrol. If we fill 14 liter petrol, obviously the car will go more than 80 km. And if you fill less petrol, then the car will cover less distance. Means more petrol, the car will cover more distance. Less petrol, car will cover less distance. So in these two examples, we can see that if one quantity is increasing, other is also increasing. And if one quantity is decreasing, other is also decreasing respectively. So such types of cases, we can say that both the quantities are directly proportional. Now let us see examples of inverse proportions. In a water tank, water is available for 50 people for 8 days. If 30 more people join them, for how many days will water last? If you can see, if 50 people are there and the water is available for 8 days, if more people join them, means in place of 50, if there are 80 people, then the water will definitely last for less days. Means people are more and the water will last for less days. Now see the second example. If a car travels with a speed of 120 km per hour and covers a distance in 5 hours, how many hours will it take to cover same distance if its speed is 150 km per hour? It is very obvious, if the speed is 120, the time taken is 5 hours. If the speed is increased, obviously the time will be less. So in these two examples, you can see that one quantity is increasing and other is decreasing, or if one quantity is decreasing, other is increasing. So such types of cases, you can see again example 1, 50 people, the water is available for 8 days, but 80 people means more people, water is available for less days, definitely. Now for second example, speed is 120, the time taken is 5 hours. And the speed is more, definitely the time taken will be less. So such types of cases, we can say that here the quantities have inverse proportions. Means one is increasing, other is decreasing, or one is decreasing, other is increasing. Now let us see the example number 1 again. Quantity of pens, we take X, and cost of pens, we are taking Y. So 5 pens, the cost is rupees 30. If the pens are 25, then what would be the cost? So here we can write, here X1 is 5, Y1 is 30, X2 is 25, Y2 is not given. Here we have direct proportion. So in direct proportion, the ratio of the quantities is constant. Means X1 upon Y1 is equal to X2 upon Y2 is equal to a constant or fixed number. So we will just put the values. 5 upon 30 is equal to 25 upon Y2. 5 into Y2 is equal to 25 into 30. Y2 is equal to 30 into 25 upon 5. If you cancel, you will get 150. Therefore,